Several signings and one big trade drastically shifted the balance of power across the NHL in a matter of days. With John Tavares going home to Toronto, Paul Stastny leaving Winnipeg for Vegas, St. Louis signing three free agents and trading for Ryan O'Reilly, the landscape of the league has changed. The Washington Capitals are bringing back a vast majority of their team. The Western Conference is loaded, and yet the Maple Leafs now appear to be Stanley Cup favorites after adding Tavares. With Paul Stastny going to Vegas, John Tavares going to Toronto, and Ryan O'Reilly to St. Louis, the makeup of the league already looks dramatically different. The associated press file photos, he's one of the best players in the league, Tampa Bay general manager Steve Yzerman said. And I think it's obvious to say that Toronto is a better team today with that acquisition. Tavares's decision to leave the New York Islanders knocks them out of contender status and puts a whole lot of pressure on coach Mike Babcock's Maple Leafs to make a deep playoff run. Losing out on Tavares despite reportedly offering more money than the Maple Leafs' $77 million over 7 years kept the Sharks from moving into front-runner status in the West, but they may not be done yet. We pride ourselves on being able to take a swing on difference-makers like this, San Jose GM Doug Wilson said. John was the one that we wanted to swing at, article continued below the Sharks, who extended Logan Couture and resigned Joe Thornton and Tomas Hertl to keep their core together, have plenty of tradable assets and will keep swinging for a difference maker. One is off the market following the Blues trade for O'Reilly that now gives them a potent 1-2-3 punch down the middle with Braden Schenn and free agent signing Tyler Bozak. O'Reilly saw the Blues sign Bozak to a $15 million, 3-year contract and wondered if there wasn't room for him anymore. Now they have centers to match up with just about any opponent in the league. You look at all the teams that have success, they definitely have guys down the middle that compete, O'Reilly said Monday. And I'm thrilled to be a part of that. The Capitals boasted depth with Yevgeny Kuznetsov, Nicholas Backstrom and Lars Eller during their cup run, and Babcock can now roll out Tavares, Austin Matthews and Nazem Kadri. Vegas lost talent on the wing with David Perron going to St. Louis and James Neal signing with Calgary, but now has a very competitive center core led by Stastny, William Karlsson and Erik Haula. We do like having centers, Golden Knights GM George McPhee said. You can move centers around the lineup, you can have centers on the wing. You can't get wingers to play center. Read more, how John Tavares became a Maple Leaf, article continued below Maple Leafs fans excited about John Tavares joining the team. Opinion, Bruce Arthur. John Tavares did what others wouldn't and came home to the Toronto Maple Leafs. Here's a look at where a few more teams stand early in the preparations for the 2018-19 season. Got what they need. Lightning, signing Tavares would have been a luxury and might have necessitated a roster makeover just to fit him under the salary cap. Tampa Bay signed restricted free agent forward JT Miller to a long-term deal. Extended defenseman Ryan McDonagh got a deal done with Slater Kogic and should have much of the same team that won the Atlantic Division last season. We try to improve our team, Yzerman said. I don't sense that we have a need to change just to change, Flames inking Neal to a $28.75 million, 5-year contract would be a nice capper to the Flames offseason that began with acquiring center Elias Lindholm and defenseman Noah Hanifin from Carolina. New coach Bill Peters could put Neal or Lindholm on right wing with Johnny Gaudreau and Sean Monahan. GM Brad Treliving's final tasks this offseason are to find a backup goaltender to Mike Smith and sign restricted free agents Lindholm and Hanifin to new contracts. Kings, long-term, signing franchise defenseman Drew Doughty to an $88 million 8-year extension is the most important thing Los Angeles did. In the shorter term, it also won the competition for returning Russian winger Ilya Kovalchuk, who GM Rob Blake believes can play with either top six center, Andrei Kopitar or Jeff Carter, and produce at age 35. That scoring type winger was something that we needed to add, Blake said. Where he plays on the power play and the way he scores goals with his shot I think is something we've coveted or looked for. Work left to do. Senators, they traded Mike Hoffman, bought out Alexander Burrows but still have at least one big problem with the future of Norris Trophy winning defenseman Erik Karlsson. The Senators have reportedly given Karlsson's camp permission to speak with other teams about a contract, which is expected to look a whole lot like Doughty's deal, which would open the door to Ottawa trading its captain rather than losing him for nothing like the Islanders did when Tavares wouldn't sign early. We start October. 4. GM Pierre Dorion said Sunday in Ottawa. We've got lots of time. Oilers, Connor McDavid won the scoring title and the Ted Lindsay Award as the player's choice for most outstanding player, and yet Edmonton missed the playoffs by 17 points. GM Peter Chiarelli publicly dangled the 10th pick in the draft to try to get an offensive defenseman and hasn't been able to acquire one yet. Meanwhile, left-wing Milan Lucic is 30, coming off a 34-point out of a season and still has 5 years left on his contract at a $6 million annual cap hit. Lucic's name has come up in trade talks, but moving him now won't be easy, so the Oilers have to prepare for life with him next season. He's a proud guy and we expect to have him back and at a better level than he was last year, Chiarelli said. My confidence level is pretty high. I think Milan's a high-character individual. Islanders, without Tavares, New York is chock-full of cap space with nothing to do with it. Ownership signaled the need for change by hiring Lou Lamoriello as president of hockey operations, and he in turn fired Garth Snow and Doug Waite, hired Barry Trotz and put on a full neutral zone trap to keep Tavares. After striking out, Lamoriello took what could be perceived as a shot at Tavares and the previous regime by saying, John has achieved great individual success on the ice with the Islanders, who missed the playoffs in six of Tavares's 9 seasons. Without a Lamoriello miracle this offseason, they'll miss the playoffs for the 12th time in 15 years.